Okay, hello. So I'm just going to do a quick review on the audiobook Mindful Communication for Dealing with Difficult People by Andrew G. Brown. So this is a relatively new one that I found in the Audible library that was recommended to me. So I listen to a lot of and read a lot of personal development books, sort of success books for business, entrepreneurship, motivation, stuff like that. I review books sort of once a week, roughly, sometimes more often than that. Last year I managed to get through about 90 books. I didn't review all of them, but I reviewed most of them. One of my goals for this year is to review pretty much just about all the books that I read or listen to. And I do it basically just to give you a bit of information. I basically give you the sort of review that I would like to come across on YouTube if I was thinking about reading a book or listening to a book on Audible. Generally, there's quite a lot of reviews online anyway, but it's just quite nice just to see someone talking for a couple of minutes just to give you sort of confirmation as to whether you want to listen to it or read it and sort of invest your time in it or not, basically. So this particular book, I thought it sounded really good, the title, sort of Mindful Communication for Dealing with Difficult People. A lot of what I do is coaching. I help staff teams and stuff who are struggling, so I thought that would be quite relevant. It is quite relevant. But what I've got to say about the book, you know, I've got slight difference of opinion on it to some of the reviews. Some of the reviews are kind of five stars, and I certainly don't think it's a five-star book. It's definitely pretty good. It's definitely worth a listen. If you're new to mindfulness, then I'd say it's quite a good kind of overview in a way. It's fairly basic. I didn't really learn anything in there sort of massive, to be honest. The dealing with difficult people bit almost seemed a little bit sort of tacked on, but that was kind of okay in the end because it was quite nice for me just to listen to something about mindfulness and just kind of have that reminder of it, really. I mean, mindfulness is really important day to day. I think it's really important in developing ourselves and improving ourselves. I think it's one of the biggest, you know, best things we can do to improve our situation is to be mindful and think about how lucky we are, you know, practice gratitude and things like that. But yeah, there were just a couple of things that kind of grated on me. The narrator, it sounded like he was a computerized voice that had been kind of programmed to read the book. It sounded a bit like a sat nav reading out. It was kind of like, nothing wrong with his voice, the bloke had a, you know, absolutely no perfect voice, nothing wrong with the way he spoke, but it was very robotic, and that did kind of grate a little bit after a while. I suppose I got used to it by the end, but it, yeah, I just thought it was a bit unnecessary. I'm not quite sure why it was read like that. Yeah, maybe that's just the way the person reads, and if that's their style, then fair enough, but it was a bit different, so that's something to consider. It felt like there was a little bit of an agenda to the book in a way. A couple of times they used as an example someone who could do with being mindful as someone who has a problem with immigrants coming into the country, and they basically said something on the lines of, you know, from a left-wing point of view, really, that, you know, they might be mindful that these people actually bring useful benefits with them and things that can actually help the country. And I thought, well, fair enough, fair point, but it just grated a little bit. It just made me think a little bit political there. And then it went on to talk about how racist Winston Churchill was, which kind of got up my nose a little bit. You know, I'm not ever excusing racism, but, you know, back in the day, there probably were quite a few people who were racist who shouldn't have been back then. For whatever reason, their ignorance and their own experiences, I suppose. But just the fact that he kind of concentrated on that about Churchill kind of irritated me a little bit. Churchill's got some fantastic lessons and quotes and stuff to teach people in terms of personal development, so to concentrate on that I found a little bit irritating, but that's just a personal thing for me. Also mentioned Jesus, or referred to as Christ, a couple of times as well, so it felt a little bit, like I say, just felt like there's a bit of an agenda there, a little bit kind of, don't really know how to word it exactly, but yeah, it just felt there's a bit of an agenda there they were trying to get across. I kind of thought, hang on, with mindfulness I prefer it to be a bit more neutral, really, and just kind of talk about mindfulness. I mean, that's what being mindful is, really, is not really having too much of an agenda or anything. Just being mindful, just appreciating the moment, you know, and kind of being grateful. So it was a good, it's definitely a good book. If you're quite new to mindfulness, I think I would recommend giving it a go. I can't remember the number of five-star reviews it got, something like 40 or 50. So I kind of thought, ooh, it's relatively new, that sounds quite good. But that's a little bit misleading. I don't think it's a five-star book. That doesn't mean it's not a good book, but five-star is pretty seriously good, I think. So it isn't quite a five-star. I'd say 3.5, maybe 4 at a push. And even that's good, to be fair. But yeah, if you're new to mindfulness and you want a bit of an overview, then you could definitely do worse than listen to this one. So Mindful Communication for Dealing with Difficult People by Andrew G. Brown. Look at it on Audible. I'm not sure if you can buy a hard copy of it or not. You probably can. I haven't checked that out yet. But yeah, if you enjoy or if you find benefit from these reviews, then please give me a like and maybe a subscribe and maybe hit the bell button as well, because that'll give you an idea of when I'm doing my next review. I do tend to do them fairly sporadically. Sometimes I'll do sort of two or three a week. Sometimes I'll do one every week, maybe a couple of weeks at a push sometimes, usually one a week. But yeah, it's all around, basically around personal development. Some of the books I read or listen to aren't necessarily personal development books. Some of them are a bit more classic or maybe fictional, but quite often I relate it to personal development in one way or another, and try and find a way that we can kind of use good writing and good books to kind of improve our lives, basically. So thanks a lot.